Connect to this. Aggregating and distributing data out of context becomes a privacy violation. I said it before, I'll say it again, context matters. There are two kinds of content that we focus on when we think about big data. That which is explicitly shared and that which is implicitly derived. There's a beautiful parallel here to what Goffman describes as being given and given off. When people share something explicitly, they assess the situation and the context and they choose what to share. When they produce implicit content, they're living and breathing the social situation without necessarily even being aware of the data that they produce. But in both cases, context matters. It shapes how the data is produced and what people's expectations are. And when you take that content that was produced explicitly or implicitly out of context, you can easily misinterpret it, and you often make it in a way that even the people who produced it didn't understand where it came from. This is why, and it's interesting, at some level we know this. And this is why as companies we keep forcing people to sign terms of use that sign away their right to demand contextual integrity. It may be legal to access this data and take it out of context, but is it ethical? Is it healthy? What are the consequences? Keep in mind that privacy is not the same as access, and it's not about access control. When we talk about privacy in technical circles, we keep coming back to the questions of what can be modeled into the system. We go back to numerical sequences like 700. But this collapses two things, privacy and accessibility. File permissions are about articulating who can and cannot access something. Privacy is about understanding the social conditions and working to manage the situation. Limiting access can be one tool in the arsenal of dealing with privacy, but it's not the same as privacy. You know, in LiveJournal, I think there's something beautiful that used to happen. It was common for participants to actually post a message and lock it and choose the actual access controls, but then go at the top and write who else could see the post and why the post was locked to those particular people. It was about defining the social situation, defining the context, removed from the specific law. Unfortunately, we keep assuming that when we see access controls that that's good enough for privacy. But it doesn't actually even begin to address the core problem.